NASA's Curiosity rover discovered startlingly high amounts of methane in the Martian air on Wednesday in what could potentially be a sign of life on the red planet, the New York Times reported on Saturday. The detection of methane would be a major discovery because, as the Times noted, it breaks down within a few centuries due to sunlight and chemical reactions, meaning it would have had to have been generated quite recently in historical terms. High levels of methane could potentially be generated underground by microbes called methanogens that survive without oxygen and produce the gas as a metabolic byproduct. Project scientist Ashwin R. Vasavada told the Curiosity Science team in an email that, given this surprising result, we've reorganized the weekend to run a follow-up experiment, the Times wrote. Video: mysterious white light on Mars seen in NASA photo, Fox News. However, it is also possible that the Curiosity rover has simply detected pockets of methane leaking from deep under the surface, the Times wrote, and the readings are only preliminary. When methane was similarly detected on the surface of Mars in 2004, scientists said that the methane could also be generated by geothermal reactions involving water and heat, though the exact mechanism by which that could occur on Mars remained an open question. Since then, research has suggested Mars may not be as geologically inert as previously thought. The Times wrote, Curiosity scientists developed a technique that enabled the rover to detect even tinier amounts of methane with its existing tools. The gas seems to rise and fall with the red planet's seasons. A new analysis of old Mars Express readings confirmed Curiosity's 2013 findings. One day after Curiosity reported a spike of methane, the orbiter, passing over Curiosity's location, also measured a spike. But the Trace Gas Orbiter, a newer European spacecraft launched in 2016 with more sensitive instruments, did not detect any methane at all in its first batch of scientific observations last year. The Curiosity rover has currently been diverted from its scheduled scientific work to do follow-up on the methane readings, according to the Times, with more data expected on Monday. Gallery: spectacular photos from space, photos. When massive stars die at the end of their short lives, they light up the cosmos with bright, explosive bursts of light and material known as supernovae. A supernova event is incredibly energetic and intensely luminous, so much so that it forms what looks like an especially bright new star that slowly fades away over time. These exploding stars glow so incredibly brightly when they first form that they can be spotted from afar using telescopes such as the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope. The subject of this image, a spiral galaxy named NGC 4051, about 45 million light-years from Earth, has hosted multiple supernovae in past years. The first was spotted in 1983, SN1983I, the second in 2003, SN2003IE, and the most recent in 2010, SN2010BR. These explosive events were seen scattered throughout the center in spiral arms of NGC 4051. The pilot of NASA's X-59 Quiet Supersonic Technology, or QUET, aircraft will navigate the skies in a cockpit unlike any other. There won't be a forward-facing window. That's right, it's actually a 4K monitor that serves as the central window and allows the pilot to safely see traffic in his or her flight path, and provides additional visual aids for airport approaches, landings, and takeoffs. The 4K monitor, which is part of the aircraft's external visibility system, or XVS, displays stitched images from two cameras outside the aircraft, combined with terrain data from an advanced computing system. The two portals and traditional canopy are real windows, however, and help the pilot see the horizon. The displays below the XVS will provide a variety of aircraft systems and trajectory data for the pilot to safely fly. The XVS is one of several innovative solutions to help ensure the X-59's design shape reduces a sonic boom to a gentle thump heard by people on the ground, though not intended to ever carry passengers. The X-59 boom suppressing technology and community response data could help lift current bans on supersonic flight over land and enable a new generation of quiet supersonic commercial aircraft. ESA astronaut Alexander Gerst took this photo from the International Space Station during his Horizons mission and commented, "We need this project for sustainable peace on our home continent and beyond, so we better not take it for granted." The SpaceX Dragon cargo craft on its 17th contracted mission to resupply mission to the International Space Station is in the grips of the Canadarm2 robotic arm moments before being released. Some of ESA's biggest science missions only got off the ground, literally, thanks to the mighty Ariane 5, one of the most reliable launchers that gives access to space from Europe's spaceport in Kourou, French Guiana. ESA has been using the Ariane family of launch vehicles right back since Ariane 1, which launched the comet chaser Giotto, ESA's first deep space mission, in 1985. Pictured from left, an Ariane 5 flight takes XMM Newton into space in December 1999. SMART 1, Europe's first mission to the Moon, gets its ride to space in 2003. Rosetta begins its 10-year journey through the solar systems, starting with a boost into space on an Ariane 5. Herschel and Planck shared a ride on the same launcher in 2009. An epic Lumbo launches in 2018 on the 101st Ariane 5 launch. Europe's next-generation launchers, including Ariane 6, will provide new opportunities for ESA's upcoming science missions to fulfill their scientific goals from their various viewpoints in our solar system. The unique capabilities of the Sphere instrument on ESO's Very Large Telescope have enabled it to obtain the sharpest images of a double asteroid as it flew by Earth on the 25th of May. While this double asteroid was not itself a threatening object, scientists used the opportunity to rehearse the response to a hazardous near-Earth object, NEO, proving that ESO's frontline technology could be critical in planetary defense. The left-hand image shows Sphere observations of asteroid 1999 KW4. The angular resolution in this image is equivalent to picking out a single building in New York from Paris. An artist's impression of the asteroid pair is shown on the right. These twin briefcase-sized nanosatellites will move around each other before performing an automated docking in orbit. The RACE Rendezvous Autonomous CubeSats experiment is ESA's latest in-orbit demonstration CubeSat mission. CubeSats are low-cost satellites increasingly used to demonstrate promising new technologies and approaches in space, as well as for educational, scientific and commercial applications. In this image made from video provided by NASA, Expedition 59 Commander Oleg Kononenko, Center, participates in a spacewalk outside the International Space Station with flight engineer Alexei Ovchian, obscured, on May 29th. The two cosmonauts open the hatch to the PIR's docking compartment to begin the spacewalk at 11:42 a.m. Eastern Daylight Saving Time. They re-entered the airlock and closed the hatch at 5:43 p.m. During the spacewalk, the duo completed the planned tasks, including installing a handrail on the Russian segment of the complex, retrieving science experiments from the Poisk module's hull, removing and jettisoning the plasma wave experiment hardware, and conducting maintenance work on the orbiting laboratory, such as cleaning the window of the Poisk hatch. The spacewalk was the 217th in support of station assembly, maintenance and upgrades, and the fourth outside the station this year. NASA's Curiosity Mars rover imaged these drifting clouds on May 17, 2019, the 2410th Martian day, or SOL, of the mission, using its black-and-white navigation cameras, NavCams. These are likely water ice clouds about 19 miles, 31 kilometers, above the surface. They are also noctilucent clouds, meaning they are so high that they are still illuminated by the sun, even when it's night at Mars' surface. Scientists can watch when light leaves the clouds and use this information to infer their altitude. This image from NASA's Chandra X-ray Observatory shows the region around NGC 1399 and NGC 1404, two of the largest galaxies in the Fornax galaxy cluster. Located at a distance of about 60 million light-years, Fornax is one of the closest galaxy clusters to Earth. This relative proximity allows astronomers to study the Fornax cluster in greater detail than most other galaxy clusters. A new study is an example of what can be achieved when telescopes like Chandra study the Fornax cluster for long periods of time. By combining 15 days worth of Chandra observing of Fornax spread out between 1999 and 2015, astronomers discovered the pairs of stars had been expelled the galaxies in the cluster. In addition to these banished X-ray binaries, the researchers found about 150 other sources located outside the boundaries of the galaxies observed by Chandra. One possible explanation for these sources is that they reside in the halos, or far outer reaches, of the Fornax cluster's central galaxy, where they were formed. Another option is that they are X-ray binaries that were pulled away from a galaxy by the gravitational force of a nearby galaxy during a flyby, or X-ray binaries left behind as part of the remnants of a galaxy stripped of most of its stars by a galactic collision. Such interactions are expected to be relatively common in a crowded region like the one in the Fornax cluster. NASA's Curiosity Mars rover took this selfie on May 12, 2019, the 2405th Martian day, or SOL, of the mission. To the lower left of the rover are its two recent drill holes at targets called Aberlady and Kilmery. These are Curiosity's 20th and 21st drill sites. The selfie is composed of 57 individual images taken by the rover's Mars Hand Lens Imager, MALI, a camera on the end of the rover's robotic arm. The images are stitched together into a panorama, and the robotic arm is digitally removed. MALI was built by Malin Space Science Systems in San Diego. Artist's impression of ESA's Earth Return Orbiter. Bringing samples from Mars is the logical next step for robotic exploration, and it will require multiple missions that will be more challenging and more advanced than any robotic missions before. Accomplishments in robotic exploration in recent years have increased confidence in success. Multiple launches will be necessary to deliver samples from Mars. ESA is working with NASA to explore mission concepts for an international Mars sample return campaign between 2020 and 2030. Three launches will be necessary to accomplish landing, collecting, storing and finding samples, and delivering them to Earth. NASA's Mars 2020 mission will explore the surface and rigorously document and store a set of samples in canisters in strategic areas to be retrieved later for flight to Earth. 100 years ago, on May 29, 1919, measurements of a solar eclipse offered proof for Einstein's theory of general relativity. Even before that, Einstein had developed the theory of special relativity, which revolutionized the way we understand light. To this day, it provides guidance on understanding how particles move through space, a key area of research to keep spacecraft and astronauts safe from radiation. The theory of special relativity showed that particles of light, photons, travel through a vacuum at a constant pace of 670,616,629 miles per hour, a speed that's immensely difficult to achieve and impossible to surpass in that environment. Yet all across space, from black holes to our near-Earth environment, particles are, in fact, being accelerated to incredible speeds, some even reaching 99.9% the speed of light. Scientists suspect magnetic reconnection is one way that particles are accelerated to nearly light speed. This illustration depicts the magnetic fields around Earth, which snap and realign, causing charged particles to be flung away at high speeds. With ESA's Space 19 Plus Ministerial Council meeting set for November, a new satellite mission called Truths will be added to the list to be financed in the Earth Observation Earthwatch program. The Truth's mission aims to establish an SI traceable space-based climate and calibration observing system to improve confidence in climate change forecasts, a kind of standards laboratory in space. It would carry a hyperspectral imager to provide benchmark measurements of both incoming solar radiation and outgoing reflected radiation with an unprecedented accuracy. Black holes are among the most fascinating objects in the universe. Enclosing huge amounts of matter in relatively small regions, these compact objects have enormous densities that give rise to some of the strongest gravitational fields in the cosmos, so strong that nothing can escape, not even light. This artistic impression shows two black holes that are spiraling toward each other and will eventually coalesce. A black hole merger was first detected in 2015 by LIGO, the Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory, which detected the gravitational waves, fluctuations in the fabric of space-time, created by the giant collision. NGC 4485 has been involved in a dramatic gravitational interplay with its larger galactic neighbor NGC 4490, out of frame to the bottom right in this image. This ruined the original ordered spiral structure of the galaxy and transformed it into an irregular one. The interaction also created a stream of material about 25,000 light-years long, connecting the two galaxies. The stream, visible to the right of the galaxy, is made up of bright knots and huge pockets of gassy regions, as well as enormous regions of star formation in which young, massive blue stars are born. Below NGC 4485, one can see a bright orange background galaxy, CXOUJ123033.6+414057. This animation shows a proposed route for NASA's Curiosity rover, which is climbing lower Mount Sharp on Mars. The annotated version of the map labels different regions that scientists working with the rover would like to explore in coming years. A flyover video explains them in more detail. Data used in creating this map came from several instruments on NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, MRO, including the High-Resolution Imaging Science Experiment, High-Rise, Compact Reconnaissance Imaging Spectrometer for Mars, CRISM, and the Context Camera, CTX. The high-resolution stereo camera HRSC instrument on the European Space Agency's Mars Express also contributed data. NGC 3384, visible in this image, has many of the features characteristic of so-called elliptical galaxies. Such galaxies glow diffusely, are rounded in shape, display few visible features, and rarely show signs of recent star formation. Instead, they are dominated by old, aging, and red-hued stars. This stands in contrast to the sprightliness of spiral galaxies such as Orhome Galaxy, the Milky Way, which possess significant populations of young, blue stars in spiral arms swirling around a bright core. However, NGC 3384 also displays a hint of disc-like structure towards its center, in the form of a central bar of stars cutting through its center. NGC 3384 is located approximately 35 million light-years away in the constellation of Leo, the Lion. This image was taken using the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope's advanced camera for surveys. Why does star cluster Trumpler 14 have so many bright stars? Because it is so young. Many cluster stars have formed only in the past 5 million years and are so hot they emit detectable X-rays. In older star clusters, most stars this young have already died, typically exploding in a supernova, leaving behind stars that are fainter and redder. Trumpler 14 spans about 40 light-years and lies about 9,000 light-years away on the edge of the famous Carina Nebula. A discerning eye can spot two unusual objects in this detailed 2006 image of Trumpler 14 by the Hubble Space Telescope. First, a dark cloud just left of center may be a planetary system trying to form before being destroyed by the energetic winds of Trumpler 14's massive stars. Second is the arc at the bottom left, which one hypothesis holds is the supersonic shock wave of a fast star ejected 100,000 years ago from a completely different star cluster. An Expedition 47 crew member photographed the Earth's limb during a starry night pass. One of the International Space Station's solar arrays is seen in the right foreground as the orbital complex flew 258 miles above the Indian Ocean in between Indonesia and Australia. Appearances can be deceiving. This thick cloud-rich atmosphere rains sulfuric acid and below lie not oceans but a baked and barren lava-strewn surface. Welcome to Venus, the second planet from the Sun, is often coined Earth's evil twin on account of it being almost the same size but instead plagued with a poisonous atmosphere of carbon dioxide and a sweltering 470 C surface. Its high pressure and temperature is hot enough to melt lead and destroy the spacecraft that dared to land on it. Thanks to its dense atmosphere, it is even hotter than planet Mercury, which orbits closer to the Sun. ESA's Venus Express studied the planet from orbit between 2006 and 2014, providing the most in-depth studies of its atmospheric circulation to date. This false color image was taken in ultraviolet light with the Venus monitoring camera on the 23rd of July 2007. It shows a view of the southern hemisphere from equator right to the pole left from a distance of 35,000 kilometers from the surface of the planet. Scientists think that Venus once looked a lot like Earth but underwent an irreversible climate change that is often used as an extreme example of what happens in a runaway greenhouse effect. This remarkable image was taken in the Terra Sabaea region of Mars, west of Aga Cavalis, by the Color and Stereo Surface Imaging System, CASIS, on board the ESA Roscosmos ExoMars Trace gas orbiter. This mysterious pattern sits on the crest of a ridge, and is thought to be the result of dust devil activity, essentially the convergence of hundreds or maybe even thousands of smaller Martian tornadoes. This image is a color composite representation where features that are bluer compared to the average color of Mars are shown in bright blue hues. In actual color, the streaks would appear dark red. Dust devils churn up the surface material, exposing fresher material below. The reason why the streaks are so concentrated on the ridges is not known at present, but a relationship to orographic lift as masses of carbon dioxide air flow uphill and converge with other air masses is one possibility. The image was taken on the 8th of February 2019 and is centered at 26.36 degrees north, 56.96 degrees east. North is up. The Milky Way doesn't look quite this colorful and bright to the eye, but a rocket launched us. So a separate deep exposure with a sensitive digital camera was used in this composite skyscape to bring out our galaxy's central crowded star fields and cosmic dust clouds. In the scene from Merritt Island National Wildlife Refuge, a 9-minute long exposure begun about 20 minutes after the Milky Way image recorded a rocket launch and landing. The Falcon 9 rocket, named for the Millennium Falcon of Star Wars fame, appropriately launched a Dragon resupply ship to the International Space Station in the early morning hours of May the 4th. The plume and flare at the peak of the launch arc marked the rocket's first stage boost back burn. Two shorter diagonal streaks of the rocket engines bringing the Falcon 9 stage back. Tone offshore landing on autonomous drone ship. Of course I still love you. How far away is Spiral Galaxy NGC 4921? It's surprisingly important to know. Although presently estimated to be about 300 million light-years distant, a more precise determination could be coupled with its known recession speed to help humanity better calibrate the expansion rate of the entire visible universe. For this goal, several images were taken by the Hubble Space Telescope in order to help identify key stellar distance markers known as Cepheid variable stars. Since NGC 4921 is a member of the Coma cluster of galaxies, refining its distance would also allow a better distance determination to one of the largest nearby clusters in the local Universe. The magnificent spiral NGC 4921 has been informally dubbed anemic because of its low rate of star formation and low surface brightness. Visible in the featured image are, from the center, a bright nucleus, a bright central bar, a prominent ring of dark dust blue clusters of recently formed stars, several smaller companion galaxies, unrelated galaxies in the far distant universe, and unrelated stars in our Milky Way galaxy. This image is of Jezero Crater on Mars, the landing site for NASA's Mars 2020 mission. It was taken by instruments on NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, MRO, which regularly takes images of potential landing sites for future missions. On ancient Mars, water carved channels and transported sediments to form fans and deltas within lake basins. Examination of spectral data acquired from orbit show that some of these sediments have minerals that indicate chemical alteration by water. Here in Jezero Crater Delta, sediments contain clays and carbonates. Dotted across the sky in the constellation of Pictor, the painter's easel, is the galaxy cluster highlighted here by the NASA, ESA, Hubble Space Telescope, SPTCLJO6155746, or SPTO6154. Short. First discovered by the South Pole Telescope less than a decade ago, SPTO-615 is exceptional among the myriad clusters so far catalogued in our map of the universe. It is the highest redshift cluster for which a full, strong lens model is published. SPTO-615 is a massive cluster of galaxies, one of the farthest observed to cause gravitational lensing. Gravitational lensing occurs when light from a background object is deflected around mass between the object and the observer. Among the identified background objects, there is SPTO-615JD, a galaxy that is thought to have emerged just 500 million years after the Big Bang. This puts it among the very earliest structures to form in the universe. It is also the farthest galaxy ever imaged by means of gravitational lensing. The constellation of Orion, the Hunter, is one of the most recognizable collections of stars in the night sky. We have noted Orion's prominent stars for tens of thousands of years at least, and likely far longer. Chinese astronomers called it Kansu or Shen, literally, three stars, for its three bright dots, which form the Hunter's belt. The ancient Egyptians regarded it as the gods Sah and Sopdet, manifestations of Osiris and Isis, respectively, whereas Greek astronomers saw a brave hunter, the eponymous Orion, with his sword above his head, ready to strike. Mythology aside, Orion is a fascinating patch of sky. This image, from ESO's Very Large Telescope, shows a reflection nebula nestled at the heart of the constellation, NGC 2023. Located close to the well-known Horsehead and Flame Nebulae, NGC 2023 lurks about 1,500 light-years away from Earth, and is one of the largest reflection nebulae in the sky. Reflection nebulae are clouds of interstellar dust that reflect the light from nearby or internal sources, like fog around a car headlight. NGC 2023 is illuminated by a massive young star named HD 37903. The star is extremely hot, several times hotter than the Sun, and its bright blue-white light causes NGC 2023's milky glow. The series of images shows carbon dioxide ice sublimating, going directly from a solid to a gas, inside a pit at Mars' south pole. As ice is lost from the steep walls of pits like this, it reforms on nearby flat surfaces. Each frame of the animation was taken by the high-resolution imaging science experiment camera, HiRISE, on NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter. The images used in this animation were taken between 2007 and 2013. The walls of the pit are about 656 feet, 200 meters, across. The University of Arizona in Tucson operates HiRISE, which was built by Ball Aerospace and Amp Technologies Corp. in Boulder, Colorado. NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory, a division of Caltech, in Pasadena, California, manages the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter Project for NASA's Science Mission Directorate, Washington. This image shows a quasar nicknamed the teacup due to its shape. A quasar is an active galaxy that is powered by material falling into its central supermassive black hole. They are extremely luminous objects located at great distances from Earth. The teacup is 1.1 billion light-years away and was thought to be a dying quasar until recent X-ray observations shed new light on it. Gaia, operated by the European Space Agency, ESA, surveys the sky from Earth orbit to create the largest, most precise three-dimensional map of our galaxy. 1 year ago, the Gaia mission produced its much-awaited second data release, which included high-precision measurements, positions, distance and proper motions of more than 1 billion stars in our Milky Way galaxy. This catalog has enabled transformational studies in many fields of astronomy, addressing the structure, origin and evolution of the Milky Way and generating more than 1,700 scientific publications since its launch in 2013. This image shows an artist's impression of the Gaia spacecraft, with the Milky Way in the background. NASA's InSight lander used the Instrument Deployment Camera, IDC, on the end of its robotic arm to image this sunset on Mars on April 25, the 145th Martian day, or SOL, of the mission. Viking 1 lander became the first mission to send back such images when it captured a sunset on August 21, 1976. Viking 2 captured a sunrise on June 14, 1978. Since then, both sunrises and sunsets have been recorded by the Spirit, Opportunity and Curiosity rovers, among other missions. Seen from afar, Comet 67P, Churyumov-Gerasimenko is usually likened to a duck in shape, but in this enchanting close-up view its profile resembles that of a cat's face seen side-on. The two ears of the cat make up the twin peaks either side of the sea. Alexander Gate, named for U.S. Rosetta Project scientist Claudia Alexander, who passed away in July 2015. These impressive cliffs lie at the border between the Sirkia and Anaket regions on the comet's head. The image was taken on the 6th of October 2014. Cerberus Fossae is a steep-sided set of troughs cutting volcanic plains to the east of Elysium Mons. Steep slopes on Mars have active landslides, also called mass wasting, and here we see evidence for two types of activity. First, the light bluish boulders on the slope appear to originate at a layer of bedrock, also light blue, near the top of the section. Second, the dark thin lines are recurring slope lineae, probably also due to mass wasting, but composed of finer grained materials. This image was captured by the high-rise camera on the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter. Comet C, 2018 Y1 Iwamoto is imaged in multiple exposures of infrared light by the NEOWISE Space Telescope. The infrared images were taken on February 25, 2019, when the comet was about 56 million miles, or 90 million kilometers, from Earth. C, 2018 Y1 Iwamoto is a long-period comet originally from the Oort cloud and coming in near the Sun for the first time in over 1,000 years. Appearing as a string of red dots, this comet can be seen in a series of exposures captured by the spacecraft. Infrared light detected by the 3.4-micron channel is mapped to blue and green, while light from the 4.6-micron channel is mapped to red. In this image, stars show up as blue because they are hotter, whereas the cooler dust around the comet, with a temperature near the freezing point of water, glows red. The Egg Nebula is a preplanetary nebula, created by a dying star in the process of becoming a planetary nebula. Planetary nebulas have nothing to do with planets. The name arose when 18th century astronomers spotted them in their telescopes and thought they looked like planets. Instead, they are the remnants of material expelled by sun-like stars in the later stages of their lives. The Event Horizon Telescope, EHT, a planet-scale array of 8 ground-based radio telescopes forged through international collaboration, was designed to capture images of a black hole. On April 10, 2019, in coordinated press conferences across the globe, EHT researchers revealed that they have succeeded, unveiling the first direct visual evidence of a supermassive black hole and its shadow. This breakthrough was announced in a series of 6 papers published in a special issue of the astrophysical journal Letters. The image reveals the black hole at the center of Messier 87, a massive galaxy in the nearby Virgo galaxy cluster. This black hole resides 55 million light-years from Earth and has a mass 6.5 billion times that of the Sun. The famous Horsehead Nebula in Orion is not alone. A deep exposure shows that the dark familiar-shaped indentation, visible just below center, is part of a vast complex of absorbing dust and glowing gas. To bring out details of the Horsehead's pasture, an amateur astronomer used a backyard telescope in Austria to accumulate and artistically combine 7.5 hours of images in the light of hydrogen, red, oxygen, green, and sulfur, blue. The resulting spectacular picture details an intricate tapestry of gaseous wisps and dust-laden filaments that were created and sculpted over eons by stellar winds and ancient supernovas. The Flame Nebula is visible just to the left of the Horsehead, while the bright star on the upper left is Alnilam, the central star in Orion's belt. The Horsehead Nebula lies 1,500 light-years distant towards the constellation of Orion.